Good morning. I'm Ralph Lucas. I'm with the operations section of Alan Sinclair's Type 1 Incident Management Team that is managing the Riverside Fire, and I'm going to give you today's operational update. Obviously, everything in red is the Riverside Fire, approximately 130,000 acres. Its perimeter is about 107 miles long, so that'll give you an idea of just how much fire is out there. Our primary objectives right now are taking care of any life safety threats. I know that is a big concern to people. We are doing really good with our resources all along this western flank. And some of you may wonder, well, why does it still show red? Or how come we haven't put any black or fire lines on there? How come we haven't lifted some of the evacuation orders? And I'll try to explain that to you so that you can understand. We're feeling real good about our control lines. Our control lines meaning that we've had resources up and down all of these nooks and crannies, all the way around, trying to clean that up. However, we still continue to find heat along the line, and we can't have the potential for any amount of fire to squeeze back out and push back out in the event that we were to have a change in weather. Another thing that people wonder about is, why can't we go back and see our homes and things like that? We have some critical infrastructure issues. We have lines down. We have fire-weakened trees. We still need to do some additional damage assessment and things like that. And that's the reasoning why we're still keeping some, and just some, of the evacuation orders in place. The overall objective is to try to take care of this side of the fire first, to get you folks back to a normal lifestyle as soon as we can. And trust me, as a team, we do understand that. We work on that all the time. And we'll continue to message and try to get you that information as readily as we can. Moving around the rest of the fire is located, obviously, out in the forest. So as resources trickle in, we are starting to serve resources into these areas and try to get around what I would consider the backside of this fire. We have other influences that are affecting that, and those are our sister fires. We have the Lions Fire down here, and we have the Beachy Creek Fire right here. So between the three fires, we are coordinating a massive effort to try to contain this entire fire regionally. And that's today's operational update.